what's going on, everybody? Hope you all are doing well. You know, if you're anything like me, you like lists. Not like grocery lists or to-do lists, but top 10 lists. You know what I mean? Did you ever have someone ask you, hey, what's your list of the top 10 greatest movies of all time? Or nowadays, people like the Mount Rushmore thing. You know, they'll say, hey, give me your list of the top 4 greatest NFL quarterbacks of all time. Well, today, since I'm a bass player, I thought I'm going to give you my list of the top 10 greatest electric bass players of all time. The problem is, when I started creating the list, I couldn't do it with only 10. There were way too many people I was omitting from the list. So I bumped up to 20. And that got better, but there were still a few that I feel had to be on the list. So I bumped up to 25 and I capped it there. The few that didn't make the list, we'll discuss later as honorable mentions. But here is my criteria for the list. First of all, they had to be electric players. Okay, I'm not doing upright players, only because then the list would really be huge. Number two, I'm strictly looking for people who are phenomenal players, not rock stars. So you'll see lists like this all the time, and the number one bass player will be like the bass player for the Butterscotch Armpits or something, just because his band sold millions of records and he's on the cover of magazines, and that's all great stuff. But I'm simply looking for players who just knock my socks off when I hear them play. Also, I found it was a little bit difficult knowing where to put people on the list. The few at the top, to me, are the cream of the crop. The rest of them, I just kind of put wherever I saw fit. I mean, how do you determine that this person should be in the number 15 slot and this person should only be in the number 19 slot, right? So I just put them wherever I saw fit. So with that being said, let's get started. At number 25 is a bass player that I have a personal connection to. I studied with him back in probably the early to mid 90s. This guy has played with everyone from Joe Zawinul to Dizzy Gillespie, just tons and tons of players. Now he's a hit solo artist in his own right. This guy is on the list because he solos like a horn player. He's just phenomenal. At number 25 is Philadelphia's own Gerald Veasley. In the number 24 slot is a guy who was good friends with our number 25 recipient. I say was because unfortunately we lost him. He passed away a few years ago. But this guy has played with everyone from pop stars like Madonna to Weather Report, everybody else in between. At number 24, it's Mr. Victor Bailey. In the number 23 slot is a guy who shares the same last name as the guy in the number 24 slot, though they are no relation. This guy's played with everyone from rock bands to jazz and fusion bands. I kind of got turned on to him first, I think, through his bass extreme series he did with the guy we're going to discuss later on in the list. At number 23, it's Steve Bailey. So at number 22, we have a guy who played with Miles Davis when he was like 18 or 19 years old. He went on later to play with people like Sting. I believe he also played with Madonna, and for the longest time now, he has held the bass chair for the Rolling Stones. At number 22, it's Mr. Darryl Jones. In the number 21 slot is a guy who actually lives in my town now. He's originally from South Africa. I was turned on to him through the work he did with Paul Simon on his Graceland album. In the number 21 slot, it is Bakithi Kumala. Number 20, we have a guy who Guitar Magazine refers to as the most recorded session bass player of all time, having played on over 4,000 recordings. He often plays with his son now, who is a drummer. Number 20 is Mr. Abraham Laboriel. cracking the top 20, we are up to number 19. This guy is nicknamed the Buddha of the bass. If you haven't checked out his lessons on YouTube, do yourself a favor, check him out. He's phenomenal. Number 19, Bill Dickens. At number 18 is a guy who has held down the bass chair in Spyro Gyra for decades now. Number 18, Scott Ambush. Number 17 is our first female on the list. She hails from Australia. I've seen her play with everyone from Incubus to Jeff Beck to Eric Clapton. She is phenomenal. Number 17 is Ms. Tal Wilkenfeld. Next on our list is a Dutch bass player who plays with the band Dirty Loops. At number 16, it's Henrik Linder. Number 15 is a New York bass player whose father was a famous upright player. This guy has played with everyone from Joe Zawinul to Pat Metheny to Joni Mitchell and everyone in between. Number 15, Matt Garrison. Next on our list, we have a guy I guess I would call experimental. This guy's played with everyone from Steve Morris to Scott McGill. Number 14, it's Michael Manring. At number 13, we have a Canadian bass player who is a founding member of the band Uzeb. I hope I'm saying his name right, Alain Caron. At number 12, we have a bass player who was one of the founding members of the band Tribal Tech. Check out this guy's fretless playing, Gary Willis. This brings us to our second female on the list. This girl hails from India. She's played with everyone from Steve Vai to just phenomenal jazz fusion acts. Number 11, Mohini Day. Well, we are now up to the top 10. Number 10 is a Cameroonian bass player from Cameroon, who is phenomenal. He scats as he is playing. Number 10, Richard Bona. At number 9 is a French bass player who has played with the likes of John McLaughlin and Chick Corea. It's Hadrian Farreau. At number 9, we have a left-handed bass player who plays a right-handed bass left-handed. You might know this guy from the Yellow Jackets. It's Jimmy Haslip. At number 7 is a jazz fusion bass player who has played with everyone from Bill Bruford to the rock band Yes. In the number 7 slot, it's Jeff Berlin. In the number 6 slot is another Philly guy. This guy has played with everyone from Return to Forever to Vertu. Number 6, it's Stanley Clark. Well, we're now up to the top 5 electric bass players of all time. In the number 5 slot is a guy who played with Chick Corea for many, many years. Number 5, it's John Patitucci. In the number 4 slot is a guy who is credited with basically having invented the 6-string bass. I don't know if he invented it, but he certainly was a guy, one of the first guys to really play it and make it famous. This guy's played with everyone from Steely Dan to Michelle Camilo. Number 4, it's Mr. Anthony Jackson. All right, now we're up to the top 3. These 3 guys, whenever someone asks me who my favorite bass players are, these are the 3 guys I mention. At number 3 is a guy who was the bass player for the Saturday Night Live band when he was 19. He played with everyone from Miles Davis to you name it. Huge session player. Number 3, it's Marcus Miller. In the number 2 slot is probably the guy who sort of put electric bass on the map for jazz. He's one of the first, one of the originals. You'd have to be living under a rock as a bass player not to know this guy. Number 2, from the band Weather Report, it's Jaco Pastorius. All right, so now brings us to the honorable mention part of the video. There were so many other guys I wanted to mention and just never really was able to get around to them, just couldn't get them to fit. So I have my little cheat sheet here, which I'm going to reference because I won't remember all these names. People like Pino Palladino, Mark King of Level 42, Tony Levin, Janet Gwizdala, I hope I said his name right. This one I'm going to butcher. Wojciech Pilichowski, phenomenal bass player. Tom Kennedy, Jeff Andrews, Frederico Malaman, and there are probably many more than I'm missing. But here we go. We are on the number 1 electric bass player of all time. It is, drum roll please. You know who it is. This guy has been playing with the band Bela Fleck and the Flecktones for many years. He is absolutely, in my opinion, the greatest electric bass player of all time. Yeah, you guessed it. It's Mr. Victor Wooten. Thank you. Well, there you have it, folks. That's my list of the top 25 greatest electric bass players of all time. Did I miss anybody? I'm sure I did. Please put them in the comments section below and put your list, too, of the top 25 greatest electric bass players of all time. Guys, thanks so much for watching, and we'll hope to see you soon. Take care.